Motorcycle and Scooter India Private Limited was registered in the year 1999, and we started with our first plant in Manesar, Gurgaon, and the production started in the year 2001. Thereafter, the journey has been very steep. In fact, we are the company which has revived the scooter market in India, and our second factory came up in 2011. At that point of time, our production capacity was 1.65 million units, and the second factory came up in Rajasthan. Third factory came up in Karnataka in 2013 and added 1.8 millions. And in 2016 February, we have added another factory in Gujarat. Now recently we have added another line in our Karnataka factory, which has taken its production capacity from 1.8 to 2.4. And currently we are having a production capacity of 6.4 million units. So last year we had clocked 5.02 million units, and this year our target is 6 million units sales numbers, and that is how the growth had been for HMSI in India. We have a fundamental belief which says that respect for the individual and three joys: joy of creation, joy of buying, and joy of selling. So joy of creation is indicative of the joy of our associates, buying is all our suppliers, and joy of selling is for all our customers. So all our stakeholders, we want them to experience joy while being associated with us. We had been associated in various CSR activities since 2006, but the real momentum came up with the change in the Companies Act, and since then we have been doing very well, and in all the places we have been spending money, all the factories wherever we operate. And I would like to give you the breakup, how much we have spent in various places. I think in Haryana, if I talk, it has been more than 15 crores. In Rajasthan also, it has been around 14 crore plus. Karnataka has been slightly higher, something like 18 crores or something, but I will have to give you the correct figure. And fourth factory also, we have been somewhere around closer to 8 crores. So this has been our expenditures in this last, I would say, over a period of last 2-3 years, if I can say. And we had been doing certain unique projects, our philosophy is that we strive to be a company which society wants to exist. So keeping in mind that vision, so far as CSR is concerned, we try to approach the societies wherever we operate, win their trust, do things for them which can create a better, harmonious, social and industrial environment in that area wherever we are operating. Key focus areas, one is safety. We had been focusing in the area of safety. We have 12 safety riding parks which we operate throughout the country, and where through which we keep on giving training to the school children, women, and now we are coming up with a driving school in Karnal. And beside that, we have recently done a project along with Haryana Police. We had signed a memorandum with them, and on NH1 we have put 20 police assistance booths for traffic management. At the gap of every 10 kilometers, these booths are there, and whenever there is a accident, so from the either side, means the communication happens and the rescue team reaches there. And these booths are equipped with a Honda bike, with the training given to these police personnels, and are manned by police personnels round the clock. And these booths also now are being loaded with CCTV facilities and the control room of these CCTVs will be within these booths. As per the latest data received by us from the government, around 160 lives have been saved on NH1 because the accident victims could be transported to the hospitals within golden hours. And just this month only on 17th, we have inaugurated the same on NH48, that is this express highway from Gurgaon to Rewari. This stretch, these booths have been inaugurated, and we will be recently inaugurating the stretch of NH2. So like it is not only helping the police in the road accident management, but also in better traffic management and also in controlling crimes in a way, because the people will be under CCTV coverage and the police presence is visible on the highways. We have motivated the farmers to plant high density fruit trees, hybrid high density fruit trees, which give the produce within a period of 2.5 to 3 years. So there has been around 100 acre plantation across the board throughout all the states where our people are operating, and now the fruits have started coming up, and this is geotagged. Each tree that is planted, the person can see the growth of the tree and they can monitor that how the tree is coming up, and this geotagging is something which is a unique feature of this whole project. Besides this safety and Harit Udan, there are several other projects like sports. We have done several stadiums at several places, and we don't believe in buying the talent, we believe in growing the talent. We have, you know, like selected some 8 youngsters in the age group of 14 to 16, and we have put them into Chandigarh Lawn Tennis Association to groom them as a players of the national standard. Similarly, we are doing it with Cycling Federation. One of the child which is being supported by Honda has got the Asian medal recently, and we are doing the same for bodybuilding. We are helping the Everesters, and we have also tied up with the Paralympian Mrs. Deepa Malik, whom we are sponsoring and helping her out for various activities that she is involved in shot put and other related events that she is doing. We do a lot for rural development. See, in Karnataka what we did, we realized that the women have to travel 2 to 3 kilometers to get the water. So we had built a overhead tank, some 3000 liters tank overhead, and from there we gave the connectivity of water to each house in the village. Some 200 taps were fitted in just on the door of the house, so that they can use that water and they don't have to bear this physical pain of going all the way for fetching the water. I think that this is a very long way to go. One thing that I want to address is that, see, in our case, so far we as a Honda are concerned, we have tied up with Ernst & Young as our partner in monitoring and assessing the impact of CSR. Okay. So each and every project which we take as a CSR, that project is first vetted by ENY. They vet that yes, it comes under the various under clause 7 of the act, and then only it is approved. Second is that the impact assessment of these activities are also done by them, and they are reported back to the board. So like this is one of the way that we, you had asked me that what are the challenges to CSR. I would say that it is the political, increasing political intervention. Now what has started happening is that all the places, the political people are interested that we should do things which suits them rather than many a times which suits society. So they want to focus it to their areas of those segments where the voting population exists. So, and then many a times they want to overdo it. So these are some of the things and which we are quite concerned. And I personally feel that the corporate should be given free hand in order to spend the CSR money rather than binding them with too many clauses. After all, the money is being spent in the society. So whichever way they think that is going to benefit the society, they should be allowed to spend. See, yeah, we are still in a very nascent stage so far as corporate social responsibility is concerned, and many organizations which are, you know, sort of having profits to the scale of, to a very high scale, maybe 6,000 crores or 10,000 crores, like public sector organizations and all, they really do not have that infrastructure to put this money, and the money really does not flows to the grassroots level, and is the corporate social activities are not visible. So I, well, the private companies are still doing it and they are visible, but I think that it has a very long way to go, and the infrastructure and the competence required to spend the money still will take some time. I think it is because, like, if you do CSR, and especially like private companies which do CSR, it helps them to connect with the local society. It creates a better relationship with the local people, and it definitely enables the companies to penetrate in the social fiber of the surrounding community, which definitely helps them, and like their acceptability in the society increases because of that. So far as the environment is concerned, I would say that slogan is blue skies for our children. Like, we believe in that, and we keep on doing activities for our children, and we are very concerned about the environment, and we are totally for it, and we think that the latest technologies should be incorporated in production of automotive products, which can reduce the emission, which can create a better environment for the forthcoming generations. See, like, collaboration could be between private companies, the collaboration could be between the government as well as the private corporates like us. See, if you see this project, the road safety project that we have done on national highways. So our collaboration is with the government. We have signed a memorandum of understanding. Then we have signed a MOU for sanitation project, which we do, in which we contribute in a big way for creating the toilets. Earlier we had signed a MOU with CAFA, CRPF Women Welfare Association body. And what we had done, we had created some 200 biodegradable toilets for various girls' schools in and around Gurgaon. And our tie-up was with the CRPF. So see, you create something, but where will the water come from? How will the water get loaded to these tanks? There is no water. So if there is no end-to-end solution, these things go as a waste. It finally turns out only as a box, which is not of any use. So the tie-up was with them, and they used to fill these tanks, overhead tanks, through their tankers. So it was a collaborative approach. Like these accidents, I would say, if we claim that Haryana police has been empowered to shift 160 people during golden hours, which has helped them in saving their lives, it is collaboration. We are giving them a support, we are giving them a facility, which is helping them in controlling crime and also helping them to shift the patients on time, reach the site of accident on time. We support them with training, we support them with all infrastructure support, but finally they are the hands of action. The power which the government has on roads, a corporate cannot have. It can only support them through such activities. I think it has been a very good step. In any case, like, we are being taxed left, right and center from all angles. So it means this money, at least we are able to spend, and it is visible that some expenditure is happening in the society for the benefit of the society. Otherwise, this would have also gone as some sort of tax and would have not been of any use to the corporate. I would also say that there has to be a support from the society in order to extract the maximum benefit from the corporates in terms of corporate social responsibility activities. Now the skill development has also come up within the arena of corporate social responsibility, whether it is rural development, skill development, safety activities, educational activities, the scope is quite large. The society should come forward in order to extract these benefits and play a constructive, collaborative role with the corporates. See, like we are a big corporate, so many a times we put up a skill training center and the expectations increase. You have given them skill, but please now give them the job. So, like, we need to understand that what is our limitations and what are the roles of the government which government has to play.